Read.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
And the knowledge of the holy.
And the knowledge of the holy
is understanding.
Is understanding. See, when you respect God, now you want to know who he is. Once you get to know who he is, it becomes easier to respect his messenger. But if you don't know who he is, it's very hard to respect God's messenger.
All right.
This is what Proverbs is about. In understanding what God has to say. Read.
For by me.
For by me, that is by wisdom.
Thy days shall be multiplied.
Thy what?
Thy days shall be multiplied.
And the years of thy life
shall be increased.
If you listen to wisdom. Who is wisdom?
God, the word of God, the knowledge of God.
Who is wisdom?
The church. God.
Who is wisdom? Y'all forgot already. That tells me you didn't even hear me. 1 Corinthians 1:18, 1:24.
Unto them which are called.
Unto them which are called. Both Jews and Greeks.
Christ, the power of God.
What's the wisdom of God? Who is Christ? See, if you lose view of who it is, then you lose view of what is being talked about. It's all in reading. Read back in Proverbs.
If thou be wise,
thou shalt be wise for thyself.
If thou scornest,
thou alone shalt bear it. Watch it. When you scorn, you're going to be by yourself. You're going to have to bear it all by yourself. Read.
A foolish woman is clamorous.
A foolish woman is clamorous.
She is simple.
She is simple.
Nothing.
And knoweth nothing. Who's that silly woman?
The false church.
What? The false church. She's clamorous. She shows off. Come on now. And you like that. But see, what... When you have a party, you're supposed to have a good time, right?
Amen.
But when you're at home, you're supposed to be doing what? Learning. You're supposed to be taught so you'll know how to go to a party and stay what you're supposed to be. Amen? You see, I taught my daughter before she left. So I can't go to Baltimore with her. She had to go there by herself. But she had all the teaching before she went. So she knows now who to lean on, right? She ain't got daddy and mama to lean on. You know, when she got sick, I couldn't run and get her and take her to the hospital. Because she was where? In Baltimore. I was in Detroit. So I had to make arrangements to get her to go to the hospital and take it from this end on taking care of the payment. Amen?
Amen.
You see, God got somebody here to help you. you get to the hospital.
Yes, sir. Come on now.
And he'll take care of the payment on his
Amen.
End.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
That's if you hear. And the Lord knoweth them that are his. Now you can play around like you his. And act like you his. But the Lord knoweth them that are his. Read, Sister Hope.
She sitteth
at the door of her house.
And on a seat in the high places.
On a seat in the high places of the city.
To call passengers
who go right on their ways.
Whoso is simple.
Let him turn in hither.
And as for him that wanted understanding.
She said to him. Now listen.
Stolen waters are
stolen. Listen. If you go back to a previous verse, what did it say? The third verse, read it.
She has sent forth her maidens.
She cried upon the highest places of the city. Who is that? Wisdom, she has sent forth her maidens. She cried upon the highest places of the city. Well, isn't that what the false church does? Both of them are crying out to you. Both of them are crying out to you. So who are you listening to? Read that next fourth verse.
Whoso is simple,
let him turn in hither. Who said that?
Wisdom.
Now, wisdom was talking in the beginning of the chapter. False church didn't come in to the last part. But see, if you, I'm trying to get you all to understand, you got to keep your mind on the subject. You can't sit here and let your mind wander off. That's what you get when you talk, or you let your mind wander. And to go back, you ever have a teacher ask you who was such and such when you're reading something? Mm-hmm. What did that say? What did that mean? You know what the teacher's trying to do? He's trying to see, or he or she is trying to see, if you comprehend it or paid attention to what's going forth. I don't want you to come tonight and leave here without being enhanced. I'll go back to the 14th verse, Sister Hope.
For she sitteth at the door of her house. On a seat in the high places of the city. To call passengers.
Who is that?
The foolish woman.
The clamorous woman. Read.
To call passengers
who go right on their way.
Whoso is simple,
let him turn in hither.
And as for him that wanted understanding,
she saith to him,
Stolen waters are sweet,
and bread eaten in secret is pleasant. Come on, read.
But he knoweth not
that the dead are there,
and that her guests
are, are in the depths of hell. Wait a minute, y'all. Did you hear that? I think you need to read Proverbs 9 again. And you need to take your time when you read it. And listen to the Lord tell you what he's talking about. Are there any questions? Are there any questions? How many want to be saved?
Amen.
Why do you want to be saved? Why don't you want to go to hell? How many of y'all like to come to church?
Amen.
How many of y'all don't like to go to church? Don't say nothing. Let me tell you. If anybody tell you they want to go to heaven, but they don't come to church, don't say nothing. Just say, thank you, Jesus. Anybody tell you that they know they're going to make it, and you don't see them in the house of the Lord, don't say nothing. Just say, thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Are you listening to me?
Amen.
Invite them to come to church. If they tell you they can't come because they're too busy, or they're big toe hurt, ask them how they're going to go to heaven. No, don't do that. Just say, thank you, Jesus. Look, going to heaven is more than a notion. If everybody was going to heaven that said they was going to heaven, we need not have church anymore. We just need to wait on the Lord. Because you can ask anybody on the street where they going when they die. What are they going to tell you? Ask them where their grandmother went. There are going to be so many grandmamas in heaven.
And mamas.
They're going to be in Johnny Cash's heaven. I know you feel lonely coming to church, don't you? Amen? Don't you feel lonely coming to church? All by yourself? Don't you wish you was hanging out with your other friends? Come on now. When tragedy hits, if your friends don't call you, you know they know you're going to the same place they go. Amen. If they don't call you when tragedy hits, you know they know you're going to the same place with them. But when tragedy hits and they start ringing your phone, amen? They know what? you've been living right. As much as they can see. Amen. Saints, this is for us to be ready. What God is sending to you is to give you recognition of where you are. How many of you have ever been driving and have been lost? And then you see something that you recognize. What do you say? Oh, now I know where I'm at. Are you listening to me? You say, now I know where I'm at. You've got to understand that. That's what should happen when you come to church. You should say, now I know where I'm at. You got to get this thing right. You know, there's going to be a lot of young folk in hell. There's going to be a lot of old folk. Grandmas, grandpas, and everything in between. You see, some folks have this idea. Grandma is so old, she has to be going to heaven. Children are so young, they must be going to heaven too. They ain't lived long enough to sin. Those all in between, they got to fend for themselves. So if you're young, you're automatically going to heaven. And if you're old, you don't live too long, so you got to go to heaven too. If you believe that, stand on your eyebrow. But that's the way folk talk. Saints, we got the best thing going. Apostolic Church of Jesus, God has blessed you mightily.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
I don't know if you know it or not.
Yes, sir.
When you begin to act like you know it, things are going to change. When you begin to realize how great a God you serve, then you'll realize that you have the best thing going. Quit thinking like the world. The problem with my generation coming up in church, we kept seeing what was happening in the world. And we wanted to be with them more than we wanted to be in church.
Thank you, Jesus.
But we wanted to go to heaven doing devilish things.
Right. Whoa. Come on now.
And now we want to keep our children from that thought.
Mm-hmm.
But we can't.
Yes,
we let them go too long. Are you listening to me?
Yes, sir.
We let them go too long. All mamas ain't going to heaven. I don't care how many tears you cry and how good she was. You know, all mamas was good when they did. am I talking right?
Yes, sir.
All mamas was good when they did. And they're going to heaven. Don't ever tell somebody their mama didn't go to heaven. Leave them alone. Just tell them about Jesus.
Yes, sir.
remember I was telling somebody about being saved. I don't know his grandmama. She was Caucasian. I say that because he was Caucasian. He said, "You trying to tell me my mama was dying? What the hell?" Because I told him, "You got to be baptized in Jesus' name and filled with the Holy Ghost." He said, "You trying to tell me my mama what the hell?" I said, "Well, you know, you're my whole one." She wasn't baptized in Jesus' name. I said, "Hey, I got nothing to do with that." But I learned to tell him, "Give the Lord to do good and do it to not." To him
right.
His sin.
Right.
You see, when you read the Bible, you'll get an answer. You'll get an answer. Because he was mad at me. I don't even know his grandma. Listen, saints. Young, old, and everybody in between. Jesus is real. Time is growing short. Time is winding up, and we got to serve the Lord while we got a chance. Don't let nobody drag you away from the house of the Lord. Things in the world look good. They're dangling before your eyes. But let me tell you this. When you touch them, they'll snatch you. And they will keep you out of heaven. We thank you for being in the house of the Lord.
Amen.
And we thank the Lord for his kindness. We trust that it has been fruitful for you to be in the house of the Lord tonight. How many enjoyed the Bible class?
Amen.
Serve the Lord with gladness. Serve the Lord with gladness. Lift up your heart and praise him. Don't let nothing stop you from giving God the praise. We thank God for his kindness to the house of the Lord. At this time, we're going to prepare. I believe everyone here has been baptized in Jesus' name. What we want to do is that you need to invite somebody to come to Bible class. Invite someone to come to service. Amen? Amen? To be in the house of the Lord. I just met someone from Prime America. I hadn't seen them in a long time. They said they're going to be at church. We hope they're going to be here. I don't know. I just hope she asked me, "Was I still pastoring?" Told them yes. So we hope that they will come.
Amen.
But we got to look happy ourselves.
Amen.
I mean, if you just stand here where I am and see your face, it's like I ain't happy to be here. It's like, I wonder sometimes, are you learning anything or are you mad at me because you're here? Amen? The Lord is